yesterday were about how IT and industry have sort of diffused, you know, lines between the IT industry and other industries. Especially when it comes to autos, you know, we talked about how the manufacturing companies and auto companies are positioning themselves to be the digital companies, not just the manufacturing or not just to be the industrial or not just to be the, you know, auto world. So things are changing rapidly in this sphere, and today we have someone who is actually come with the background, who has implemented programs in different states and the digitization, who's passionate about IT, and who sits in a vantage position where he's actually able to see the entire landscape of the country. And we have somebody who's also passionate about transportation and auto. That's what he told me about 1.5 months ago, and he promised that he will be here, and we have no other than the secretary for the Ministry of IT and Electronics here, Mr. Ajay Sawhney himself, and please welcome him to the stage.
Exponential to be the norm. but we have always expected the arithmetic progression, not the geometric one, to be the norm. We grow at 7%, 10%, if we are going at a very brisk pace, we grow at 12% or 15% in some period. Whereas the exponentials are basically in a different range. We are growing at a compounded rate of 30%, 40%, sometimes even more. The exponentials have been largely confined to the virtual world. And the arithmetic rate of growth has been the norm in the physical world. IoT is the bridge which actually helps the exponentials leap out of the virtual world and come right into our physical world. Things that we can touch and feel. Our home, our vehicle, our environment. One by one, I think the virtual world is now leaping out of the virtual and coming right into our physical world. That change brings along with itself the potential that instead of the 5%, 7% kind of growth and aspirational rates of 12%, 15% per year, that change can come much more rapidly and to some extent in a possibly a disruptive manner as well. I think IoT represents that potential. As communications become sort of all pervasive and technologies move into different dimensions, large number of sensors, everything becomes connected, not just people making use of the internet, but getting connected to all kinds of instruments and things in factories, in homes, in vehicles. We start getting the benefit of this phenomenon. So, this is the world that all of you are today in, and this is the world which you are helping us take forward for the country. In this, already there are excellent experiments, excellent technologies that many of you are offering. The vehicles themselves are changing in character. Globally, it is expected that electric vehicles will be a major game changer. In India, we are still seeing only an initial sort of warming up to the idea. The world now expects that very soon after EVs come in significant numbers, autonomous vehicles will follow. In India, we are still a little hesitant in sort of fully embracing this concept, primarily because we feel that maybe our roads and our transport systems are not yet mature enough or ready enough to move into that dimension. But some of the thinkers have been anticipating and predicting very quick change. One thinker, Tony Seba, talking about transportation in a paper termed Rethinking Transportation 2020 to 2030, has actually talking about the US first, that in the context of the United States, that EVs would come in very strongly and be the norm as early as 2030. And that IC engine vehicles will start giving way to a very new and different generation. In his conceptualization and articulation, it will not just be confined to the US, it will be a global phenomenon. And the same thing will follow with a few years lag as well as that. In India, to my mind, we, in many other fields, we have actually taken advantage of our not having a saturated market with the current offerings of technology. Especially mobile phones, which everyone mentions. Now, without any landline phones in every home, we were able to jump one or two generations, and suddenly we find mobiles everywhere. And we find that technology benefiting India and Indians at price points which are hardly seen anywhere else. And at levels of sophistication which are also hardly seen anywhere else. Even in this area of, you know, when it comes to a new wave, when we are at the early stages of the wave, of IoT, of how IoT can get applied to every dimension of transportation of vehicles, of vehicle to the, you know, to the infrastructure or vehicle-to-vehicle kind of communication and synergies. This is again opening up a large number of new opportunity areas. And there is once again an amazing opportunity that we could skip one or two generations, or we could move quickly across the existing technology regimes and migrate to something else, hasten the process, accelerate the process, bring it forward. If we determine that the outcome that these technologies promise us is good for the citizen, it is good for the environment, it is good for the country. It is good for the country in terms of safety, it is good for the country in terms of environmental impact, it is good for the country in terms of reducing the use of our energy intensity in transportation. It is good in terms of the demands it places on natural resources. And if we finally determine that yes, it is good for the country, it is good for the citizens, it is better, then there is also an opportunity to together make it happen, and make it happen quicker, faster than it would happen in the normal course. So, many things which you are contributing are all part of this beautiful system. One other point which I would like to quote another favorite researcher of mine. This I'm bringing the thoughts from Jeremy Rifkin. He's an the marginal costs for the society. When IoT comes in and this kind of exponential technologies, exponential impact of technologies are seen, then the costs can come down dramatically in communications, in energy, and in transportation. Transportation includes transportation of people and logistics, transportation of goods. Bringing down the costs is very important for the country, because the cost structure is a key component of the competitiveness of the country, its economy, its participants. If at any point of time our closest competitors in the global arena start enjoying a very low cost of communications, ubiquitous availability of broadband, extremely low marginal cost of communications, they start enjoying a very low cost of energy, you know, with widespread use of renewable energies, and they start enjoying very low costs in transportation and logistics, where all of you are contributing to that change. Then for India not to be there in the same league, not to be bringing down the costs of these critical ingredients to the economy, critical building blocks to the economy, means that we lose on competitiveness vis-a-vis others in the global economy. So it's again from that perspective as well. Fast forward, moving quickly with the newer technologies, bringing them in not just as experiments, not just as pilots, but as scaled up offerings in the market, is very important. Because as any company, you would also like to ensure that whatever is the benefit of these technologies, we are able to bring those benefits into our economy. We are able to help almost all the participants in the economy enjoy the benefits of these technologies and enjoy the, especially the cost reduction benefits that these promise to bring. These are some of the thoughts I have on the broad area of IoT. When we bring these technologies into vehicles, into transportation, the benefits in terms of not just cost reduction, but availability and affordability of services which can help us expand the market to this huge, unserved, underserved, you know, population which still doesn't enjoy many of the transportation and logistics services. That potential is immense. The potential of eventually, when we sort of move to EVs and beyond, the potential of safety on the roads. Again, experts say that there is a huge potential there. So I would only like to mention that the work you are engaged in, please look at it as a very important ingredient of a much larger effort. And you should not stop with just simple and small experiments, incremental experiments. Please think big and please help the country go big in these directions. Thank you.
the industry from the government side. Both of them want to see how powerful it could be if Arjuna get more powerful than they said. So this is a fireside session because yesterday we had so many discussions, you know, so many new ideas that were discussed, and we get to hear some of those ideas, you know, what Secretary has to say, and a sort of fireside chat session, you know, now for next half hour.
Wanted to pick up the cue, a lot of things that you said.
like participation in this, making use of this technology. Energy sector is another area which again because it is of as a building block for the economy. Again, in that sector there is good, very good possibilities. In industry, back to the industrial IoT, that of course cuts across large number of industries. Again, within the industries, we may have to sort of prioritize and see which sectors move along with the IoT and others more quickly. So, these are some of the key sectors that I
the challenge seems to be
implied, is to actually work together with the sector in order to create these exemplars of the company. Is that something which you see the COE or IOD helping to build such partnerships with different sectors? In this event itself, I think we've seen a lot of people from the automotive sector. We had for some of you, both of us happened to be from the Andhra Pradesh cadre in the IAS. We had the chairman and the managing director of the state transportation corporation here yesterday. And they were looking at how these technologies could be used. I was very happy to find that the user entities also have come to this event. Usually, we tend to have a lot of providers who talk to each other. But users, I think that's a good sign. So, building those kind of partnerships, would you say that that is something which actually should be probably important?
Yes, in fact, the strength of the Center of Excellence that Nasrom and Meti have R&D issue gets resolved. But from there, the translation into something which is a product or service available across the board, across a wide swath of the economy, that becomes a challenge. That is where the startup ecosystem comes in. Because then, startups work almost 16 hours a day and work at a very different kind of intensity. And suddenly you can translate something which is half done. Because I think you are going with, you have to go to the market. The only outcome that the startup requires is getting to the market. So whatever R&D has to be done is a long way. It has to be done. So bringing these two together, I think, is what COE should concentrate on. These new silos that we have of fairly high quality, excellent R&D,
yeah,
and the startup ecosystem to plug into that and to sort of draw it out from wherever it gets stored and bring it into the market.
So basically what you're saying is that between the high quality sort of somewhat academic research which is being done in these institutions and the market, the applied research is something which the startups have to incorporate into their business plan and not focus merely on exploiting the market but also on adding value from a technology point of view in enhancing the value. But I think that's interesting and a very pertinent thought for all the startups who are aiming to create a USP for themselves. And I know there are a lot of other things that I would like to discuss. I've had the pleasure of knowing Mr. Ajay Sawhney for many, many years. We have actually worked alongside each other for almost 3 decades now. And he's a very accomplished person, one with a very deep interest, knowledge, and experience in technology, all aspects of technology. So I don't want to hog this opportunity by myself. I don't certainly want to leave the floor open to people from the audience who want to ask some questions. But before doing that, I would just take your perspective as the Secretary of the Department of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Just one broad, sweep question as to how you see the adoption of these technologies and the march towards a digital India going. And do you see the country moving forward at a rapid pace? Do you see the ability and capability of the society and the economy to absorb technology as being ahead of any other countries or behind? Or more or less on par. Just a broad sweep which forms the background for what everyone here would want to be doing.
Actually, the foundation that is now in place, as opposed to what was obtaining in the country even 5 years or 10 years ago, particularly the three things: the banking financial inclusion, the bank accounts being available to everyone, Aadhaar being near universal today, and mobile being almost all pervasive. It is moving wherever it has not gone. Those frontiers also, I think, we can expect to see very rapid movement in those and in the rural areas.
much readier than the country has ever been in the past with the JAM and Aadhaar and the whole startup ecosystem and the IT industry and so on. So it's, there are huge opportunities, and I think now let me open the session to a few questions from the audience. If you can have a mic, yes, you already have the mic, so we come to the
good afternoon, my name is Timaya. I think there's a good discussion that you had in terms of product development or in terms of technologies. I personally feel there's another element towards, you know, deployment and getting into the market. Quality, reliability, and dependability. Quality, reliability, and dependability of these products. If at all we need to compete globally, we are good enough, you know, developing products here. And we are not looking at it globally. If at all we are looking at developing these products and marketing globally, these three things are very important. Is there something that both Government of India and NASCOM have some focus on this aspect of it? In having a better quality product, having a much reliable product, and very, very dependable product.
Domestic market, which we are losing out to.
also to get a share of the global market. So what are your views on preparedness of the MSME, not the big industries, and the support from the government? Thank you.
There's a large number of steps that have been taken by the government is now having a very significant impact. but hopefully Mr. Sawhney is here for another hour or two, and maybe we would like to have some time to interact with him formally. But I do thank you for being here today. Your presence actually means a lot. This is the first major event of this kind. It brings together the creators of these technologies, startups, the user industry together. And I think your being here certainly is a huge encouragement for everyone. For me personally, also, it's a great pleasure to have you here. As I said, we've been working together for a long time. It's been also a matter of great happiness, I should say, that a number of wonderful people with whom I've had the privilege of working very closely have been here as IT Secretary, Mr. Satyanarayana, Mr. Arun Sharma, Mr. Saruna Sundarajan, Mr. Ajay Sawhney. So I think it's really wonderful to have people for whom I have a lot of respect and who have tremendous knowledge, interest, and experience in this area. And that certainly augurs well for the sector. And we can look forward to a lot of very informed support to the industry, which is important as we meet the challenges ahead. Thank you very much for being here, and thanks to all of you for being a great audience.
Thank you, sir.
Support for this. So we are truly fortunate and thankful.